Hello, everybody. I've got a quick review here, and I just picked up a Wenger Patriot. It's just a simple knife here. It's got the penknife blade. It's got a clip point here, and it has an interesting A-lock. It's not A-locks in the sense that it doesn't have like the ridges and the bumps that you see on other A-locks knives, but it is aluminum scaled, and it is extremely thin, as you can see. This one here has got some damage on it. I picked it up used off of eBay, just basically because I thought $24.97 was a bit steep for this blade, and that doesn't include shipping. So I still think that way even now that I have one, but I still think it's a great gentleman's blade. Now let's do a little test of my, see if I fixed my camera, see if I can get, there we go, come on, you can focus. It says, I don't know if you can see it very well. Can't tell if my viewfinder is doing its job here. Oh, sorry, and also, I'm having to hold my camera, so there we go. It says, Wenger, Delmont. Oh, that's unfocusing again. It doesn't really matter. Wenger, Delmont, Switzerland Stainless. And I'll show it to you closed, hopefully without hurting myself here. And this is closed. So, definitely a gentleman's knife, definitely easily lost in your pocket. This thing is just going to disappear on you. I'm not even sure it weighs an ounce. If it does, it's not much more than 1 ounce. Built very well. All the tools snap pretty good. I think you probably heard that. One thing is that the blade isn't all that much different from my Tinker's blade here in shape, but it is 1 millimeter thinner than, or so thinner than the blade here, so it makes this thing quite the slicer. Now, to go along with the price point, I paid, I don't think I even paid $10 for my Sen Renmu here, which is a great gentleman's knife, and I use it all the time when I'm not working. And although I'm probably going to carry the Wenger for a while, just for novelty, I still love this Sen Renmu. Just a great blade. And it's been holding up really well. The price difference is good too. I bought that new for less than 10, and I mean, the Wenger, it's $24.97 on Wenger's website. And the lowest price I saw it for brand new was $20.97, if I remember correctly. So, you know, I just don't think it's worth that kind of money, even for the quality you are getting. I would, if you're going to get one, unless you're a Wenger collector or a Swiss Army knife collector, I'd buy one used off of eBay. I mean, that's what I did with my Tinker here, because, you know, I use this thing all the time and beat up, and it was, you know, beat up when I got it, but does what it needs to do, and only paid like 10 bucks for that too. So definitely an interesting shape and design as well. This one does not have the toothpick. It does not have the tweezers, and does not have a keyring, a bailer, or any type of lanyard hole. So yeah, basically it's in your pocket only. There's no pocket clip. However, still a good blade all in all. I do like Wenger. I'm not sure which I prefer. They're Wenger and Victorinox both have great blades, and there are some that I prefer from one over the other. For example, the Wenger Standard Issue has the Bailer, which is the like the Victorinox Soldier. I'm not talking the one-handed Soldier. I'm talking the pre-2008 ones. Definitely, you know, I prefer the Wenger in there. But then there are some Victorinox blades that I prefer as well. Although, I can't really think of the ones offhand. So, anyway, great knife. Pick one up if you have some extra money to spare. And I hope you enjoy the rest of your day.